I got attacked by a dog.
He's looking for a place to pee. Say, come on, George. Take him where you want to go. Say, come on, George. Don't let him go. Look. Now we got to get his leash back.
Hey, guys. What's up? So today is just a morning like any other, but I thought I would let you know I got attacked by a dog. And it was my own dog.
What's up, George? Good morning.
I know George and Bodhi get on amazingly and that I'm always there when they're around each other, or at least somebody's already there, always there when they're around each other. But that doesn't change the fact that I don't actually know what George is capable of around a two-year-old, because this is his first time around a two-year-old, and the same can be applied for I was obviously unaware what my dog could do around an 11, 12 year old, because I was 11 or 12 when I got attacked by my dog. So let me give you a little bit of history about the dog. The dog was a former police dog. It was a long-haired, I want to say a long-haired Alsatian, but it could have been a long-haired Labrador. No, definitely Alsatian. And he was called Arnie, because he was a beast. And one day, for whatever reason, I let him off the leash as normal on the fields, and we were just walking around. He was chasing things backwards and forwards. I was throwing balls to him. I was loving it. This is what I did every day. Nothing out of the blue. And then all of a sudden, he started coming bounding across the field a little differently than normal. I realized as he was heading towards me at full sprint, I had my younger brother on my shoulders, who at the time will have been two or three, forgetting that Arnie loved my younger brother more than he loved me and thought I was hurting him, so was en route to protect my younger brother, who just so happened to be my shoulders, and he was moving at a speed where I couldn't get Will down in time, and I'd imagine if I did, it could have been even worse. So this dog is now less than a foot away from us. I've got my three-year-old brother on my shoulders and he's not coming over to play. Now, don't get it wrong, I think the dog was doing what it was trained to do. It was trained to protect. It was a police dog. So I wasn't mad that it was trying to protect my brother. I was scared out of my mind because it was protecting him against me. Now, I'll describe it the best I can whilst brushing my teeth. I'm a stay-at-home dad. I gotta multitask while the kid's lying down right now. But, like you see in the films where the dog comes and it gets on you, changed the arm for my lower leg and it dived on me, locked its jaws around, dragged me down. Thankfully, I was able to put Will onto the ground, and then I rolled onto my back and pushed Will away because I didn't want nothing to happen to him. And then I proceeded to kind of go into a fetal position, and the dog just kept going at my legs. He never actually broke the skin but in one place, but it did scratch me up. It did scare me. It growled me. It was no longer looking at me like its owner. It was looking at me like I was a bad guy, or looked at me like I was a criminal, or looked at me like someone he had to stop. And he was pinning me down, and every time I got to go back up, he jumped back on my chest and started going at my legs again. And I'm telling you, I was so scared. I was screaming. I was like, probably at that point, I'd started to move backwards when I had him on my shoulders, and then I put him down, and I was probably still about 500 or 1,000 yards away from where we were living at the time, and I was screaming, "Mom! Mom! Mom!" But crying, screaming. And to kick it off, I had sports day at school that day where I had to wear shorts, but my legs were all tore up and I was embarrassed that my own dog had attacked me. So I wore trousers, track pants for it, and I never used to do that, and people asked me a bunch of questions because I did, and I ended up having to show them. I was upset, I was scared. But when this dog was coming, you know when it's like, and it shows you its teeth? It wasn't like a fun, it was a, I want to kill you, and I was screaming. And then eventually, I believe my mom came running out and she grabbed it by its collar, dragged it down to the ground, and then I actually run into the house because I was so scared. I didn't want to see the dog. I run upstairs and shut the door, and I was like sat in my bed, like really scared that my own dog had just attacked me. Yeah. Needless to say that we didn't have that dog for much longer. It's kind of a rule of thumb that if you get attacked by your own dog, or your dog attacks somebody, that dog has got to go the journey. So I was very upset that my dog then got taken to the pound. I was away on a holiday, and when I came back, there was no dog there anymore, and it was not really ever spoken about in my house what had become of it. If your dog can't be trusted around children, it shouldn't be around children. So we removed Well, my parents removed that dog from the equation. I was very upset because I didn't have a dog anymore, but in hindsight, kind of grateful because I didn't want to have to deal with being attacked every day, because that wouldn't have been fun.
George, go to Bodhi. Run. Stay. Stay here. All right, you get in front of me. Ready? Crouch down. George! Come here, George. Let's go. Woo, he's coming. Yeah, good boy. Good boy. Say good boy, George.
Let me know if you've ever had any issues with any animals like that, and I'd love to hear it in the comments below. But that's the end of today's video. Hope you enjoy it, and we will see you tomorrow. So I'd love it if you can thumbs up the video, share the video, subscribe to the channel, and see you tomorrow.